Hi everyone, welcome back to Beeston Fields Early Years Home Learning. Today we are learning phonics, and it is really important to learn phonics because it helps us with our reading and our writing. So if you have your phoneme mats out at home, you can get these out, pause the video and go through them. Remember to use them when writing a word or a sentence as well, and look at the pictures to help you to remind yourself of what sound it makes. If you don't have them, don't worry, Miss Johnson's going to go through the flashcards up on the screen with you today. So make sure that you say the sound out loud back at home. Let's get started. Or, o, oi, u, z, e, ow, g, u, z, a, u, E, P, K, Sh, D, Y, ear, o, I. Okay, so Miss Johnson has linked below on the school website the tricky word song that we've been doing all week, our phase three ones. You can sing along and have a go at practicing writing them, or even write a sentence using one of the tricky words from the song. So today is a little bit different. What I've done is I've done a little revisit of all our phonemes of the day this week. So we're going to have a little look at all of them, so see if you can remember which ones we have been learning about this week. So we're going to look at this one first, so have a think. What is that phoneme? What sound is it? It is air in chair, and that's the action for it. So it's air, and it's our trigraph because we've had a few trigraphs this week, and we pop that sound button dash underneath. So air in chair. What about this one here? Have a think. What sound does that one make? It is in mermaid, and we did that, should be yesterday. Yeah, yesterday. So in mermaid with our dash for the digraph. What about this one? It can make two sounds. You can guess both of them if you like. Yeah, it's, we looked at this week, oh, in book, but it can make ooh in moon as well. And our last one, which is our trigraph, because it has three letters that make one sound. We did this one the other day. It is ooh in treasure. So we've got air, up, and and as you can see, they both make the same sound, these two, but they look different. The spelling of the grapheme is different. So today we're going to sort the objects of all the different graphemes that we've been looking at. So we're going to look at the pictures here and sort them into the right graphemes. We've got our air, our up, our and So this is a pair of socks. So the word here is hair. So we could sound it out to try and hear the sounds. Three, two, one. Air, hair. So which one would it go under? It starts with a p, but that's not on there. And then the other sound is air. So I'm going to pop that one in the air for pear. Now the next picture is treasure. And we should probably know this because it is on the phoneme mat. So have a little look for the treasure chest and see if you can find the grapheme. So treasure, does it have the sound? Or also which if it is. So treasure. So it has the sound in, but which one is it? So I'm going to check on the phoneme mat and we look on the bottom. It's this one. It's got a picture of the treasure on there. So I'm going to move that one under here. You can print this off and cut and stick this yourself as well if you wanted to, because the PowerPoint is available on the school website. Let's have a look. You can't see this picture very well, but it's a hook. Okay, so it hooks pictures up on your wall. So hook. So does it have a up or a Let's sound out hook. 3, 2, 1. Hook. Hook. So we've got a that's not on there. Is that on there? Yeah, it's a digraph here, so I'm going to pop the hook under up that we've been learning this week. Sorry if you can't see that very well. Now we've got a picture of flowers or flower. Okay, have a think what that one's got in. We're going to have a go at segmenting and blending to help us here. There is one left, but we need to check if it's not tricking us. 3, 2, 1. Ooh, ow, flower. So it's got a not on there. Ow. Ow in cow's not up there. And the last sound is flower. So it's got our our in mermaid, which is at the end of this one here. Well done, everyone. We have sorted the objects. Let's have a look what we're up to next. So using the objects, we're going to have a go at writing it. Miss Johnson has popped up the phoneme phrase. If you can just see, there are two boxes here that Miss Johnson goes on about boxes all the time. So I thought I would definitely show them today. So we're going to have a go at writing pair for pair of socks. So we say the word pair, pair. 3, 2, 1. Pair. Pair. And use your phoneme mat if you need to. Remember the air is up there. What's the first sound in pair? It is a p, 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 p. Good job. So I'm going to write my p on the board and pop my lonely sound button dot at the bottom. So my p. And the next sound in pair, p, air. The A-I-R spelling in pair. And I would pop the dash underneath for the sound button. So A-I-R for p, air. Pair. Now we're going to have a go at this one. Hook. Say it together. Hook. 3, 2, 1. Hook. Hook. Make sure you've got three boxes. If you don't want to use the boxes, that is fine. You can just have a go at writing them on a scrap piece of paper. So what's the first sound in hook? It is a. So this is a tall letter. So make sure you get the tall stick. So we go down, up, around, flick, popping that dot underneath for the sound button. What's the next sound in hook? Oh, and it's our oh, the one that we've learnt this week, the digraph. So the O-O spelling for oh. Again, it's a digraph, like I just said, so we pop that dash underneath for the O-O spelling in oh. Now we've got one more sound, one more to go in here. Remember, each sound goes in the box, not letters, okay? So last sound, 3, 2, 1, hook, hook. And this time there's lots of k on this one, but just so you know, it's the k, the kicking k. We have a go at writing that one in the last box. Again, pop that sound button down, cross down, okay, for hook. Now they get a little bit trickier, but we're going to have a real good go at it. We did have a go at treasure the other day, And remember that E is an EA spelling. So Miss Johnson's going to go through this one as well. You can pause the video too and have a go independently if you want to. There are T, R, E, Sh, E. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 boxes for this one. So it is a bit tricky, but we're going to have a go at it. So treasure, 3, 2, 1, T, T, T is the first sound in treasure. T, R. So these are the lonely graphemes. So I'm popping that dot underneath. So my T, R, T, R, E. Sorry, my voice. I need a drink. Eh. And like Miss Johnson was saying, the eh here is the EA spelling. Okay? Because sometimes the EA makes an E sound, but in here it's making a eh sound. Okay? T, R, E, Sh. And it does make you want to put this one. Our. And rightly so, a lot of the time it is that one, but it's trying to trick you in this word. So it's just a s, which is making that sh sound in sometimes in some words, because the English language is pretty tricky, but we can have a good try at it and we'll get better and better at it that we keep if we keep trying. So last sound in treasure, t, r, e, sh, r. And this is our up here, the U-R-E spelling for to finish off our word treasure. T-R-E-S-H-E-R. Now, we've got the last one, flower. F-L-O-W-E-R. And there are 4 boxes here. So if you want to have a go, again, pause the video. Please do have a try. Even if you're unsure, you're finding it hard, you're being really resilient and having challenging yourself. So flower, we're going to say it and segment it. Flower, 3, 2, 1. F-L-O-W-E-R. Flower. And a heads up, there are 2 digraphs in this one. So the first sound in flower is a f. So no tongue is out. So it's the f, the F. And I'm going to pop my sound button underneath again. Flower. F-L-O-W-E-R. Just the L on its own, not the digraph. Next sound. F-L-O-W. And that's the O-W, our digraph. Ow. And you can find this on your phoneme mat. Ow in cow. Ow. And again, pop that dash underneath, O, W, dash. Now we've got one more sound in flower, F, U, ow, and it's this that we were learning about yesterday, the ER spelling. So you can check your work on here to make sure that it's correct. If you made a mistake, do not worry. That is fine. Miss Johnson does it all the time. She's done this video many times. I've had to delete it. So do not panic. What we're going to have a go at now is a lot of you have enjoyed the yes, no questions. So it is a question because it's got a question mark at the end. So a yes for thumbs up to answer it or a thumbs down for no. You can pause the video and have a little go by yourself independently, or you can have a go with Miss Johnson. Remember, you can segment some words if you already know them. There's no point. And tricky words we cannot segment and blend. So Miss Johnson is going to segment all of them to show you if you're finding it too tricky. So let's have a look at the first word. 3, 2, 1. K-A-N. Can. Can. A. Next word. F-L-O-W-E-R. Flower. Back to the beginning. Can a flower. Oh, it's got that up here. Ready? Hook. Hook. Back to the beginning. Can a flower hook a. This one here. Ch-air. Chair. Back to the beginning. Can a flower hook a chair? So a hook is where it hooks onto something like a picture I showed you previously. It's hooking a fish. Can a flower hook onto a chair? What do you think? I suppose you can bend a flower, but really it's not a great hook, if I'm honest. So no, not really. Flowers grow, you can make a daisy chain out of them, but hooking them onto a chair, not really, no. Right, last thing that we're going to do is have a go at writing a sentence or a phrase. So you can have a go at writing, they got a pair of socks or pair of socks. Or if you want to challenge yourself even further, you can come up with your own sentence using some of the graphemes that we have learned this week. You could even try and use and, the conjunction and, to join words or phrases in your sentences. Always remembering a capital letter to start your sentence, finger spaces between your words, and a full stop at the end of your sentence. So Miss Johnson's going to write, they got a pair of socks. So they has been our tricky word that we've been spelling this week. So have a think, what letters make they? It's T, so Miss Johnson's putting that capital T at the start, H, E, and that cheeky letter at the end, Y, because it looks like a the, then it has a Y. So they got, so I put my finger space, G, oh, my G hasn't come up right, so I'm going to try again. I'm going to rub it out, or you can cross it out if you don't have a rubber at home. Got, my G needs to sit on the line as much as possible. So G, O, T, got. So they got A or A, so finger space again, A, around, up, down, flick for my A. A pair. Now that's using one of our graphemes of the week. So p, air, pair. So again, my finger space, I will remember. I know it starts with a p, p, p. And if I'm unsure, I'm going to have a little look on my phoneme mat. Air, A-I-R spelling. So I'm going to pop that on the line there. A-I-R for pair. They got a pair of. Now it does sound like a V at the end because it's tricking you. It is an O and a F for of. This is a tricky word as well. They got a pair of socks. S-O-K-S. Socks. So what does socks start with? Remember that finger space. Next sound in socks, s-o. Next one, s-o, k-k-k. And this k is the digraph, so it's the C and the K. And the last sound in socks, because it's plural, which means there's lots of socks, has a s-o, k-s. Socks. And to end my sentence, I need a full stop. So I've put my capital letter to start my sentence, a full stop to end my sentence, finger spaces between my words, and now I just need to check that it makes sense. They got a pair of socks. Great job. Now you can have a check of yours. If you've made a mistake, like Miss Johnson did in hers, I tried again. I edited my work to make it even better. I hope you've enjoyed this phonics video today, and Miss Johnson will be seeing you very soon. Oh, and any work that you do for phonics, pop it on Tapestry so the Bees and Field staff can like and comment. Bye.